What I know about Marist, I know the coach. I worked a camp with him about 12 years ago, so that's about all I know about Marist.
What were you kind of expecting or hoping for going into the night? Obviously, you're hoping for top 16, but was there anything else that you're looking at?
No, there's no easy way to the World Series. There's absolutely no easy way to the World Series. Every year we get a different type of draw, and right now it takes a little bit of time for us. What we're going to start the process right now, looking at all these teams, looking to see how many of them we have film on, et cetera, et cetera. I know this, my three buddies are the three of us, Mike Kendre at Arizona and Clint Myers at Auburn. We all three graduated from Arizona State about the same time, and we've stayed in touch. And it looks like if we're going to get here, we're going to have to go through them. So, and I'm sure they're feeling the same way.
What's this night like now when now you're thinking, well, we're going to be a top 16 seed, maybe we're a top 8 seed, when this hasn't always been guaranteed back in the first couple of years here? You're wondering if you're going to make the field. What's the difference in knowing where this program is and where you guys built it?
Well, at this point, what we're looking for is to get as high as we can be. And one of the things that's, every little thing affects you. We lose that 8-inning game to LSU, we might have been totally different. One game out of 56 games that you play. So it's just nice to be considered one of the top teams in the country every year. And I'm proud of our players for getting us there. And a number 13 seed is certainly not a bad seed when 298 teams start the season playing Division I softball. So I'm proud of where we are. We've got a tough battle ahead, no doubt. Some very good teams en route, and we've just got to get out of practice tomorrow and get ready to try to get to Oklahoma City.
And we hit on with a couple of your players, and like he said, starting out, I didn't even know if you'd get in the field, but now we get towards kind of an expectation of Tennessee. What's it like to host at Tennessee once again?
Well, it's great, and our fans are going to see some great softball. Like I said, in Marist, they've got a great record, so they're probably a pretty darn good team. And Arizona is definitely a good team. We lost a 1-0 ball game to Arizona earlier in the season, a leadoff home run, and nobody scored after that. And I know what a great coach he is down there and what he does. In Ohio State, we played against those coaches when they were at Miami of Ohio about 4 years ago, and they beat us in the opening round. So they've got good coaching too, and playing in the Big Ten, they'll be seasoned. So what I do think is this will be a great regional for our fans, and I hope we have a sellout every game.
Is there an update on Rainey at this point? Is she?
No, there's not an update. And, I can't give out the medical things, but I think they're probably about ready to make a release here pretty soon about her prognosis.
No, I know all attention is on Marist at this point, but it would be nice to have a rematch with Auburn, SEC, and looking at Arizona. What's it like to hopefully get past Marist and have a potential matchup with these teams?
It's never nice to play Auburn or Florida or any of those powerhouses, but if that's what it comes up to be, Auburn's a great team, obviously a great team. They got the player of the year. They got a great pitching staff. They pitch by committee. They've got the top of their order is like the 1927 Yankees, so, what the heck, Oh, yeah, I'm looking forward to that. I just hope we get there. We got to get through some pretty good ball clubs to even get there.
And what is it like for your seniors going into this one, though? When you go into the SEC tournament, you don't know if that's going to be their last game at home, but you do get another chance to play at UT. And for these seniors, that's going to be a big deal. So what's it like for them going into this tournament?
Well, I hope that it's very enjoyable, and I hope that they get to put the uniform on one more time here at home and have a great time. I really wish we knew about Rainey, because Rainey's right now, she's the leading hitter on our team, and also a very good pitcher. But it'll be exciting for him.
What changes without Rainey? What do you have to do differently?
In playoffs, if things go as they should, you really only need two pitchers, because you're only playing once at the most twice every day. And that two times doesn't come very often. So we've got two pretty darn good pitchers, and Bria Bush is coming along fine where she is. So I don't think we'll miss Rainey as much pitching as we would hitting. You know, as I said, the last stats I got, I asked for stats for the top 20 games, and she's on top of that list. So, you know, that's going to hurt us. Her speed hurts us. And then again, probably something I'm forgetting is her leadership. She's a great leader, and she's very fiery out there on the field and just the kind of person you want in there when the going gets tough.
How do you deal with losing a player like that this late in the season? I know you went through it with India Childs back in 07. She was able to come back later on. But how do you approach that with your team?
Well, you know, you just got to be honest with them. I mean, you know, you got to be up front, and somebody's got to step up. You hear that all the time in sports. But when somebody's got to step up on such a short notice and such a big stage, it's tough. So we spent the day in practice trying to figure out, you know, we put together a lineup against LSU just right after it happened for one day, but we've got to get our lineup solidified and decide who's going to play where. And you say, well, just one player, but Rainey was the center fielder. Rainey was in the top six in the hitting, and Rainey was also the top relief pitcher. So, you know, it's a big hole. No doubt.
And we know there's always things to work on all the time, especially before tournament. If there was, you have something that you're trying to nail down, something specific that you're trying to nail down right before tournament starts.
No, not really. We just need to polish everything up. I thought in the LSU game we took a lot of strikes that we should have swung at. And if anything, I want us to be more in an attack mode. It's kind of interesting because not in any way looking ahead to Auburn, but the only way we were successful against Auburn was we were in attack mode, because Auburn is a better hitting team than most anybody you'll see. I mean, they're just amazing hitters. And whatever happened that day is not indicative of their season nor our season. You know, we'll just see what happens if and when we get there, and we got a big hurdle to get over to get there.
Thanks, Coach.
Good luck,
thank
Coach.
You.
Mm-hmm.
16 teams to be named, and y'all are number 13.
I wouldn't say it's stressful. I say it's more exciting. It's just exciting to see your name pop up on that screen and know that you're moving on into postseason. We're just excited to see the other teams that we're going to play this weekend and just get prepared for them.
So the chip on your shoulder not to be a top 8 seed and one of those super regional hosts, or is that matter at this point in the year?
I would say it matters, but I wouldn't say it's a chip on our shoulder, just because it's an honor to just be going on to postseason, and even more an honor just to be in the top 16.
Being in the top 16, how does it feel to at least get a game or two more at UT and right before the season ends?
Yeah, it's a big deal to get to play at home, especially in regionals. And we have a really good record at home, and it's somewhere that's comfortable we like to play. So it's a big deal to get the top 16 seed.
And how are you feeling about going into the tournament and where you all are right now? Do you think you need where you need to be, or y'all going to try to work on some things? How do you all feel going into the postseason?
Yeah, there's always things we can work on, always improving, always getting better. So we're going to take some things that we learned last week about ourselves and just apply them this week and be ready to go.
Does it help that you have, you know, at least one team you're familiar with? You played Arizona already this year. Does that help at all in preparation, or does it really not matter at this point in the year?
Well, right now, our first game is against Marist, and that's all we're really thinking about, because we have to beat them and play them before we move on anywhere else.
Any more questions? Right, thank you, Erin.
Thank you.
Comfortable at home. Why, is that why y'all are so good, or is there something else about playing at home?
I think being at home, we have a really good fan base, and that gives us a lot of energy and support. So I think we do really well with our fan base behind us.
How tough is the losing Rainey Gaffin at this point?
You know, that's it's tough, but we have to look past it. We love Rainey, and she's a really good player, but we still have games to win, and we have a whole all these other teammates that help us. So.
See Arizona coming in Knoxville, you've played them this year. What's your thought having at least one familiar face in this region?
It's good to know a team, but like Erin said, we have another team to worry about before we even can start thinking about Arizona.
I believe this is about 11th or 12th straight year you guys have been able to host a regional. What does that just say about the state of this program and how dominant you guys have been able to be? Not just in the SEC, but nationally.
It just shows that we have a really good tradition here. Lots of hard work and dedication, and it's something that we really work hard for.
Any more questions for Meghan?